Hey guys, welcome back to Home Built, and in this episode we finally have some of the parts I've been waiting on so we can move forward on the Ferrari. Alright, those of you watching previously will have seen that last couple of episodes I've been working on the wheel arch flares on the Alfarrari, and I'm really happy with how they've come out. I'm happy with them fiberglass, and having the hidden fasteners and stuff I think is the right way to go on this build, and the right look to match them with the bonnet bulge and everything else. I am quite happy. If you missed out on that, I'll put a link up above so you can catch up. And if you're not subscribed, please think about subscribing. It does help us out. On these flares last week, I mentioned that I was going to do the welding of the inner and the outer later, but I've decided I want to do it now before I move on. So the first job this week is to get in. I'm going to cut basically along the join line of the inner guard, move it out to the outside, and line it all up and weld it onto the outside. And then I should be able to weld a joining strip in the middle. Even if I just tack it up for now and get it all in place, and I can do the final finish work on it when I get on the rotisserie. All right, let's start cutting. Okay, so you can see here, I spot welded, and I went over with the MIG on quite a few spots all the way around and just tacked it all together all the way around. And you can see I've got this gap here that I now have to fill, and that's where I've gone. Thankfully I have a guillotine, so I just cut some strips. So I'm going to start now adding these strips in all the way around and zip them all together. At least I will MIG them all in for now, and I can TIG them together fully when it's on the rotisserie. All right, it's not pretty, but that's got a strip all the way around inside now, so I can move on to the other side. All right, so both sides are done now, so it's time to move on. Okay, so I'm happy now that I didn't just leave those wheel arches. I've done them all, they're looking good. I need to start tackling the pedals. I definitely have enough brakes. They are coming. There's a, keep an eye out, but there's a big box on its way from a very cool guy named Chris in the UK. I will give you more details about that when it comes, but I'm very excited about the brakes. But we need to be able to power the brakes, and in that case, we need master cylinders to run it. And thankfully, Colin Byrne, I've mentioned before, you need to check out his channel. It's fantastic. It's just his name, Colin Byrne, building his Stratos. And he's also raced these Alfa 105s in the past. And he came up with, on his race car, a dual master cylinder setup, so that you, with brake bias adjustment, which is fantastic, because that's what I could use on this, particularly because I'm changing the brakes front and rear. I need to be able to adjust the bias to get it right so that I don't sort of slam on the brakes and the rears lock up and the fronts do nothing, or vice versa. You want to be able to play with that, and that's where a dual master cylinder with a bias bar really works well. That's what I've got on Harry the 911, and it works great. So I ordered a bunch of parts and they months ago, and they finally arrived with a bunch of mast cylinders and a brake bias balance bar. This is the balance bar. So basically all these do is when you have this fixed in the center and the pedal pushes on this center bearing, by winding one way or the other, it actually winds where the pivot point is, and that gives bias to front or rear depending on how you've got it set up, and you can adjust it. And in this case, this kit, I've actually got a an adjuster knob on it, so I'll be able to fix this knob to the end of the pedal and be able to adjust the bias in car on the fly, which should be a really good addition to this car, particularly with the power it's got. It needs to stop. So, as I mentioned, Colin Byrne designed this thing before, so I got another bunch of cutouts. Again, this is not really a proper kit. It's something that Colin cobbled together and was good enough to share the design with me. I'm sure it's probably gonna take a little bit of extra tweaking and stuff, but we'll get it in and working. So the way the pedals work in the Alfa is they're actually floor mounted, four hinge pedals, similar to the 911, and the mast cylinders are actually back almost under your butt underneath the car. And they're on an arm, so the pedal sort of levers at the front and it pushes a rod underneath, and the mast cylinders are actually under your seat. What I'm doing is I'm going to use the original sort of mounting locations and original bars and hopefully the original pedals themselves, at least for the brake and the clutch, and remake them so that they actually fit the new brake bias setup. So let's start seeing what I can do about cobbling this thing together and see how it all fits in the car. I really like playing with these things that Colin's designed. Basically, it's like a jigsaw puzzle. There's no instructions. It's just, you know, a bunch of parts. And I've got to sort of play around and get it to cobble it together so that it sort of makes a little bit of sense and that I can work out how it's supposed to go in the car. So basically what you can see here is we've got the two mast cylinders on the back, we've got the bias bar on the front, and there's a pivot. I just stuck a bolt in there for now. And you can see that the bias bar, I've got to make a... like a tube for it to sit in that I can weld to these pieces, and the pedal will be connected to this end here. So as the pedal gets pushed, it will pivot through and press the brakes. At the moment, it's knocking this whole thing apart because it's just sort of lightly cobbled together, but it's a really good design. Colin's actually added in some adjustability holes for adjusting the pivot point of the pedal. I'm really a fan, and this will fit into basically the factory location so that I can keep using the factory pedal. Fantastic design, thank you very much, Colin. All right, so now it is time to start working out how I'm gonna put this together. That means tacking the basic framework together and also trying to make some sort of mounting for my balance bar. Okay, so I have tacked most of this piece together, except I still need the bottom plate in, but I'm gonna leave this off for now. That's a reinforcing plate and it's easier to get in and weld it without this last piece on, so that's good for now. Obviously my two mast cylinders come in through from the back and join in the middle on these. These are pivot points to obviously push the setup and push the mast cylinders in with the pedal. Now, I've done a bit more looking at how Colin designed this, and basically these little spots here, these are the adjustable holes for where the pedal arm attaches. So basically when you press the pedal of the car, you press the pedal like this, it pushes the arm backwards and forwards. So this arm will pivot like so. So what I need to do now is make a pivot that fits in this spot nicely to sit between. Basically it's got to sit into this gap here. Both of these parts will pivot together. So it's time to start getting out on the lathe. I found a piece of rod that I've got here that's just about the right size. All right, so what I've been doing is I've turned myself up a tube here. So this tube is going to be the pivot for this arm that basically the pedal will connect on the bottom here, push through here, and this center part here will connect up to the master cylinders to give the leverage to push the master cylinders themselves. This will be the fixed pivot point at the top of this unit here. So this unit here, well, this will be in the middle there, and it'll pivot through that these holes here. Now, to do that, obviously it needs to have some sort of movement. I'm just using a bolt is not good enough. I'm going to make myself up, hopefully, some bronze bushings to go in either end of this tube so that it will bolt nicely into this space here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start making up the first of my bronze bushings and see how good I am at it. I haven't done this before. I've got plenty of bushing material that I got when I got this lathe. That was one of the benefits of getting this nice secondhand lathe. I've got lots of material. Hopefully I don't need much of it to make up a couple of bushings and see if I can actually do something that's going to work nicely in this situation. So, fingers crossed, bronze bushing time. Alright, I feel like I'm actually getting a bit better on the lathe. Basically what I've done here, I haven't chopped this to length yet, but I've turned down my sleeve and recessed the... I've already got a bushing in one end, that's one of the bushings I made up. This is the other bushing right here, made up for the other end. Now I just need to work out what size I need, and then I can press this bushing into the other end, and we should have the pivot bar. I'm really happy. I can actually use a lathe that is passable. That is fantastic. So that is exactly what I was looking for. I've got a bushing either side that is perfect. These will be welded on, these two arms, so they'll be the pivot. I won't weld them on yet because I want to get, I'm going to use a rod end, either end on the arm coming off of the base of the pedal to go through here, so I've got to get myself some M8 rod ends. And then this bushing is perfectly sized to go in here and give me some pivot, and I'll be able to sort out the pre-tension with some nylock nuts on the end of this, some good quality nylocks, and I should have a nice solid pivot that's actually got some bushings in it. It's not actually just, wearing away at stuff. I am really happy with that. That's the first time I've actually sort of been really happy with what I've used on the lathe, and I did leave the key in the chuck. I keep doing that, and I've got to stop it. Now I need to make up another piece on the lathe that needs to be for the balance bar to slide inside of. So some internal turning this time. Let's see how that goes. All right, I am really happy with that. That's another piece done. So this tube took me quite a while to turn up. That fits the balance bar in nicely. It's a nice tight fit, and it can still move left to right, which is exactly what I wanted, so that we can adjust the bias of the brake balance. And that will basically sit I have to probably grind these out, these holes out somehow, and actually sit these into this spot right here in these holes. And then of course we've got our the other plate and the bushing that I made up earlier that's going to sit up there. So we've come a long way. There's a lot of time spent on the lathe, but unfortunately it is the Easter long weekend and I am out of time. But it does mean it's time for Fun Facts with Mrs. Jeff.
Hey guys, by the end of World War II, Enzo Ferrari started to get back into designing race cars and he commissioned Gioacchino Colombo to design a new V12 engine. This tiny 1.5 litre V12 engine became known as the Colombo engine and it was used by Ferrari in road cars and race cars for over 40 years in capacities up to 4.8 litre. In 1946, Enzo Ferrari released specs and drawings of his new car to the press. And in 1947, he started Ferrari SPA. SPA stands for Società per Azioni, which basically means a joint stock company. Apologies for the Italian pronunciation. Along with this, the first official Ferrari car was released, which was the 125 Sport. Enzo took the 125 on a road test on March the 12th, and by May the 11th, 1947, the first two badged Ferrari cars entered a race. These 125 Sports are the only two ever made of that model. And although they were only raced in that year, they won a total of 6 races between them.
All right, it's good to be onto something a little bit different and getting stuck into those pedals and getting some work on the lathe. I'm really happy with how that stuff came out. It took a long time. I'm not quick on the lathe. I'm learning, but actually turning out stuff that I am happy with that actually looks like it's supposed to is a good thing. So we'll get back into it next week.
Yes. Yes, we will. With more expert lathe working. Obviously, I don't want to have a go because I don't want to show Jeff up and make him feel inferior on the lathe because it's a bit of a secret talent of mine. Yeah. If you'd like to see the videos a day early without ads, please follow us on Patreon.
And like, subscribe, do all that sort of stuff, and we'll see you in the next one. See you guys.
To build the first V12. No, it's not right. Tiny 1.5 V12 litre in... What? Enzo took the 125 in its first road test on March the 27th, 12th. There were 2 badged Ferrari cars around. Tiny 1.5 litre V12 engine was...